Site selection is a critical component of making a good ADCP measurement. Today, I'm here on the Blue River near Breckenridge, Colorado, in high flow, and I'm going to talk to you about some of the very important considerations when you're picking your site for making an ADCP discharge measurement. So number one is you want to make sure that you have uniform flow across your cross-section. So you don't want eddies or pools or those kinds of things. You want a straight reach of channel with all of the water confined to a single channel and a more or less uniform cross-section. So you don't want wide, shallow areas in your cross-section. That straight reach of channel should be about 10 channel widths long. So 10 channel widths, you shouldn't have any control structures, bends, upstream or downstream within about 5 channel widths. This is because we want a uniform flow velocity across, or uniform flow across the cross-section. Next, we want to make sure that you can access the site. If you're going to be making measurements in high flows and low flows and flood flows, then you need to make sure that you can access the site and make an ADCP measurement at all of those different flow conditions. We want to make sure to avoid any vegetation, if at all possible. The vegetation will disrupt the flow, and it's not an ideal place to measure, so you may have to periodically clean a cross-section if it's critical to make a very clean discharge measurement at those sites. Want to make sure that your site is within the instrument specifications. So is your channel within the depth range and the velocity ranges of the particular ADCP that you're using? So those are the main considerations. And so next we'll step into setting up the software for your ADCP measurement.